Welcome to this instructional video for the Ocean Health Index. Today we're going to go over how to install and launch and explore the Ocean Health Index application. So to start, from the website OHI-Science.org, there's some commands that you just need to copy and paste into the R console. So R is the statistics software upon which this is based, and it's free, open source, cross-platform. Here are links to the website in general in R, and then directly to the install files for Windows or Mac. And all you need to do is copy this code, and this is a one-time install, or if you want to update the software later, as will be in active development. So let's copy this and then open up, let's close this, let's open up the R window and then paste these commands. Okay, so I let everything run, and here it would look something like this. You can ignore all the blue text messages versus the red pasted code. And then this final line, after the libraries are installed, launches the application. And so with that, you should see something like this, whereby we have this first data tab window, and then within that data tab, we've got a map, histogram, and table window. And then over here on the sidebar, we have the ability to choose different variable types, whether it's an input layer or an output score. And I'll show you the sub-selections available there. And just to get a little oriented now with this mapper, as I hover over a given region, we see in the upper right over here the score and the region name, and then its ID in parentheses. You see the legend here with the minimum to the maximum score, colored from red is low and blue is high. And we can click and hold and pan through this mapper. And we can zoom out or zoom in. And if we click on a given region, it'll zoom to that region. We can also go full screen, and now we're in this immersive view where we can still use this zoom in and out. So let's exit full screen. So that's the map, and then the histogram just shows us the frequency of values. This is a binned histogram in the and as the bar graph, with and then the polygon in red is a density, a smooth density frequency. So then the values, the min and the max, are on the x-axis. And then also for this given variable, we can see the actual values here. So in this table view. Or we can, for instance, go directly to a given value by searching for it. And we can also sort by, let's say, the lowest or the highest value. And see, in this case, the overall output score as the index score. So this is the final Ocean Health Index score per region. And you'll also notice that there's a special region here called Global, which doesn't show up on the map, but is the Global Ocean Health Index score. And then we get some descriptions here about what the index is, and then what the dimension of score is, and then some summary information. Okay, so now let's look at other variable types. We can look, for instance, at for output scores. We can see that now we've got this listing of the goals, and in some cases sub-goals is where there's an extra decimal place. So fisheries and mariculture are sub-goals of the food provision. Similarly, livelihoods and economies are sub-goals of coastal livelihoods and economies, and so forth. So we can choose these different dimensions, the overall score, either for the index or individual goals, or resilience, pressures. So the score is made up of half the current status and half the likely future. And the likely future is determined by the current status, the past trend, and how it gets inflected by into the future by downward by pressures and upwards by resilience. Okay, so we can, for instance, choose another target, and we can now see that target, food provision. We can go to a sub-goal and see those scores. And we can, for instance, look at even pressures specific to fisheries and those scores. Okay, so now let's look at input layers. So now here, input layers are organized by by their targets where they get used. So the same input layer can show up in multiple places. But for instance, this is organized by, here are the input layers for food provision, which is just one layer that weights fisheries and mariculture. We can look at, let's take another look at something like natural products, where we have multiple layers that get used. And here we see fishery status. We can look at something like the harvest of marine resources. And this layer actually has multiple categories within it, and then years within that category. So in this case, it chose the first category of corals and the most recent year, 2009. And we see that reflected up here. And we get, again, the values. Gray means that there's no data available. It's not available. And again, we have the histogram of values and a table to also peruse. And here we see this category in years showing up here. We can, of course, change the year or the category. So that's the overview there. And we can also peruse these goals. You might try to reduce the screen size if you need to fit things within your screen. There's also the scroll bars here. And the idea of this goals tab is to simply provide little sliders so you can play with and see how the overall scores might change were you to weight certain goals less or more. So further out to this outer circle, a given petal in this flower diagram goes, the higher the score. And that the width of that petal determines the weight. So here, fisheries and mariculture are weighted as much. They're just sub-goals, so normally they're half the weight. But here, we're weighting them to the full one. Or we can cancel, drop them out completely, and see the reflected, updated score overall ocean health index as those weights change, in this case for the global region. Okay, so initially, I'm going to do another video for the details of calculate and report, but I just want to show you that to then get this default scenario, which is the global 2013 results from our 2013 web launch. So here we have a version number associated with this scenario. We can write this to disk, and this defaults to your home directory. And when we go to that folder now, we see all the elements needed to calculate the ocean health index. And what I simply want to point out for the sake of this video is that, well, one, to cancel this, when the application is initially loaded, we get this little help, a little helpful disclaimer about how to stop the application from running in the background. You can press escape or control C. So let's hit escape, and now we see it grayed out. So I'm going to just go ahead and close R and this application is no longer available. But now we can go into the file system and we can run this launch app, and it will go ahead and invoke R and get us right back where we left off into the application. Okay, thanks for your attention, and stay tuned for the next video, which in which I'll show you a little bit more details on the calculate and report tabs.